This live stream is being brought to you by Reed Spring High School's Advanced Video Production Media Team. Thank you for watching and enjoy the event.
Tonight's stream is being brought to you by Millennium Bowl, where the good times roll, and Kay's Coffee, where relaxation brews.
Respring, number one, Jimmy Andrews. Lions up victorious, Kirby, who first team cup two. Thank you. 6-1.
Hello, everybody. And now you have a beautiful voice to commentate and talk about the beautiful content on your screen. I was late again. Last game I was late too, but basically the JV only played two quarters. Media team was not informed. So, yeah, that's my excuse, but from the few plays that I have seen in tonight's game, it seems like the Wolves are getting good opportunities
and putting up, you know, some shots.
Just not as much as they are not making a lot of those shots is what it seems like. Kalina has already done a good job getting to the hoop and finding some open shots. And right there, Shelby Straley scored a second chance basket. So it does seem that, you know, all is well. Look for the inbound there. No shot taken, surprisingly, as did have the height. Marshfield did have the height on the Wolves, but just nothing gonna happen there. Oh, jump ball travel there. Blue Jays miraculously maintain possession. One thing that I feel like the Wolves do a good job of is that defensive pressure from Kalina and Shelby Straley, and I mention it more than likely every single game, but it is they do a great job of forcing that pressure and creating turnovers, and as you can see, there's a turnover right there, and I'm literally sure that there'll be plenty more turnovers just based on the way the Wolves play and the pressure that they force. I've seen many fingers on Blue Jays passes by the Wolves. Kalina for three off the front of the rim, but Tara Sampson to score the second chance points. Wolves are starting to eat away at that deficit, trying to get back, you know, actually in the game to where they can create even more pressure, you know, as they have been on a little bit of run that does create pressure to the Blue Jays. They start to, you know, play a little bit more tense and stressed. And if the Wolves can get within 4 points, 2 points, or even flip-flopping, you know, back and forth, having several lead changes based on whoever scores, that would be the best opportunity for the Wolves to create that pressure. Brooke Davis will be subbed in for Shelby Straley. And on the court for the Wolves, we have Brooke Davis, number 20, number 24, Tara Sampson, number 1, Jenny Andrews, number 11, Victoria Scobie, and number 13, Kalina Asbill. Like I said, plenty of fingers on the ball. Just unable to defend that shot, although they did a great job of putting putting the Blue Jays in an uncomfortable situation and forcing them to make a play. Tara Sampson to shoot the second chance opportunity. Instead of Tara passing out or anything, as she fell back, she kind of had to shoot. Especially as she was falling back, she didn't really have much of an option. Will be a travel by the Blue Jays. .250 left here in the first half. Stolen from Kalina. It is interesting in basketball. I don't watch a lot of female sports, basically, such as volleyball, tennis, cross country can be a little different because lots of times they share the same coach. Well, I guess lots of sports they share the same coach, but basically what I'm saying is lots of times it seems like we see male girls basketball coaches, and I just think that's interesting. I feel like in volleyball most of the time it's women, just because typically women are they play volleyball. So it makes sense for them to coach it, but with men, you could have, you know, a high school, college basketball player who then coaches female basketball because, you know, the basic things are the same. So, I don't know. It's interesting to see that Bluejays coach is a female. Nothing, obviously, against females, but it is interesting to see. I feel like there are very few in the field of coaching, but just interesting to see. Although the Wolves have a full female staff when it comes to their girls basketball coaching. Good job by the Wolves to get in there, and Brooke Davis will shoot 4-3. That one falls. Brooke Shaw just falling a little short. But other than that, I mean, the Wolves are getting high percentage shots. Ginny Andrews to shoot the mid-range. Nothing there. We'll have a push by Brooke Davis. Maybe if Brooke would have, you know, crossed her chest or, you know, set up for that charge, she would have had something. But instead, Brooke's hands went out, not really to affect the other player, but more to, like, catch the other player, catch herself, kind of. But that does create a foul for the Wolves. Victoria Scobie subbed out for Shelby Straley. Now the Wolves, that is their 17th foul. They're shooting 1-on-1 here. Tara Sampson, great defense there, forcing the Blue Jays to shoot over the top there. Now you can see a huge difference between the speed, it looked like the effort between defenders there. Kalina was running as fast and as hard as she could to break up the play. Didn't seem like the rest of the Lady Wolves were. Blue Jays are reading a lot of passes from the Wolves, and that, I think, that's an issue. Will be a reach-in foul there. Foul on number 22, her first. Ginny Anders at the line. And Shelby Straley to be taken out once again. The run the Wolves are on has suddenly stopped. Ginny Anders to shoot 1-on-1. Second now. Ashley Nolan will be subbed in for Brooke Davis. Falls for the Blue Jays. Lena Asbel doing a great job with the behind the back there. She She'll now drive to the hoop. No foul there, but it will stay. White ball as it's knocked out off of a Blue Jay. This weekend was All-Star Weekend. I'm not sure if anyone watched it. I didn't. I watched some highlights from the All-Star game, and it seemed like it was probably one of the best All-Star games in a long time. Kyrie Irving and LeBron really throwing it down together. Dunk contest, that was great. Had some wonderful dunks. And it's a Vince Carter throwback. That was lovely. I'm not sure if anyone knows what I'm talking about, but was good to watch, and it was a really good All-Star weekend compared to what it has been in the past. And lots of times in all sports, you have like the Pro Bowl in football, All-Star game in baseball, and basketball. And lots of times they're just taken as like, you know, just, whatever. But this year's Team LeBron won 148 to Team Curry, which had 145, I believe. 3-point spread there, but I don't know. It was a – usually it just – I don't know. It's kind of taken as a joke. Players don't try as hard, but it was really cool to watch some of those highlights. I watched a 9-minute video on YouTube of highlights of the game. Anyway, that wraps up our first half. 17 Wolves, 34 Blue Jays. We'll get back to you after some student created commercials with the help of Mr. Locke, our media teacher. But we'll get back to you soon. Thank you.
Pop's Dairy Del has been family owned and operated since 1958 in downtown Reed Springs. For over 50 years, Pop's has been serving locals and visitors classic diner food. Burgers, fries, and onion rings are all made fresh to order. Soft serve ice cream is on hand for your favorite sundae, or try a flavor burst cone with any combination of our 8 great flavors. If you like quality food made fresh to order, Pop's Dairy Del is the perfect choice.
Thank you. Can I help you today?
No thanks. Just looking. Oh, this is cute. So?
Too tight, hey!
You wouldn't do it there. So, don't do it here. Sportsmanship. It's up to you.
Like they're the fashion police.
ago was opened in 2001 by two guys that were looking for a better way to provide auto care to the area. Some of the things offered at AutoGo that set them apart from the competition include free loaner cars, a full courtesy inspection on every vehicle that comes in, and high quality customer service. Come to AutoGo for the best auto care around.
The ReachSpring Athletic Booster lends support and assistance to all ReachSpring Wolves athletics. It is their goal to enrich student involvement in all team activities by providing extra equipment and support items that cannot be funded through normal school budgets. In order to achieve their goal, they rely on the help of dedicated volunteers to raise funds through various concessions at the high school athletic events. Join the mission and show your support for ReachSpring Wolves Athletics. Contact Coach Gosch today if you're interested in helping the athletic booster support Wolves Athletics.
In 2012, a few students at ReachSpring High wanted to get information out about current and upcoming events in their school and community. From this, they created the Pulse magazine. The Pulse mag is 100% student-made, from the ideas, themes, writing, and photography, to its edit, production, and printing. This magazine provides a look into student life, sports updates, entertainment, a school calendar summarizing upcoming events, and much more. Visit us online at the ReachSpring High School homepage to find our link.
By me. I'm number one in this class. I rule this lab. I'm number one. Hey, I don't think so. Yes! Winner! I am a king!
Woo! You wouldn't do it there. Woo! So, don't do it here. Sportsmanship. It's up to you.
What?
Jerk.
Inside my heart there's an emptiness, a heavy hate on a hollow chest, so unspoken like a disease, is the way to incomplete me. Can you shake this all night, shoot my breath to the highest height, tell your truth or trust a lie, is this hello? Is this the low or is this the high? Higher, 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 higher.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back from halftime as the new half gets underway. The end of last half, we were talking about All-Star Weekend. Hope you guys went and watched some videos on it. I'm sure you didn't. Wolves are going to have to really bounce back, come back very strong as they are down by 17 points. They did get on a run about midway through the second quarter, but it's going to take a lot to continue to keep that run up, to stop the Blue Jays from scoring. As you can see, Blue Jays are reading passes very, very well. It's created a lot of turnovers and, I don't know, just a lot of issues in general. Shelby Straley to get a steal, and she will miss the open layup, and that'll force a jump ball. Will go Blue Jays ball. Free points or fast break points, those are points you can't miss. You miss those, you end up losing games, and you got to try to eliminate those. You have to make the unordinary play extraordinarily well. One of the most important things a coach has ever told me. You know, a lot of people want to make that amazing play. They want that amazing play, that diving catch, that huge pass. Even basketball might be a dunk or a no-look assist, you know, whatever it is, or to break someone's ankles. But you have to make the ordinary play extraordinarily well. And when you can play at an extraordinarily level, when you can make extraordinary plays and play at an extraordinary level, that's when those, you know, crazy, amazing plays will come. But if you can't make those basic plays and the ordinary plays, what's the use of being able to make a great play? Also, another saying is that offense wins games and defense wins championships. I've never really understood how that's the case. Excuse me, but I don't know. I just won't be an and one there. And or an opportunity. Foul on number 11. It is Victoria Scobie. It's her third team foul. But what I was getting at is, you know, like, I don't get why one of them wins normal games, regular season games, but the other one wins championships. I don't really think that's like a – she will convert three-point play, and now Brooke Davis to be subbed out. But I don't really think that that actually is a – I think that's more of like a defensive players one time just started saying this so they feel better about themselves. Could be wrong, but it is what it seems. Another notable thing to mention tonight is that this is the last game I'll ever announce. I don't believe there will be a playoff game here for the boys or the women. So, yeah, unfortunately, I guess this will be the last game. It is kind of sad. Like, lots of times I don't know, not lots of times. There have been some times where I don't really want to go. Or, I mean, basketball is different because it's three or four games a week randomly throughout the week. Well, not randomly. I mean, you get the schedule, but it's not like football. Every Friday, I can count on going. And football, the culture of football as a sport is totally different, especially where we live. And so that was a little bit more fun, but overall it is the last game. My brother, who coached football with me, I believe he announced his last game, and, you know, I don't think he'll be coming to this. So I have no clue who will be here next year. I have no clue who will be here in the spring for baseball. I'm sure Mr. Locke will be again. I know that I will not be, as I play baseball, and my brother will not be, as he plays baseball, and Luke McFerrin will not be, because he plays baseball, and so, yeah, I couldn't tell you who will be. I wish the best luck to them, though. And a chance there, but Victoria Scobie just overshooting the basket just a little bit. Kalina will fall, but keep the dribble going. Now Shelby Straley will be fouled on her way up. She will be shooting two. Shoots the first, that one does fall. To shoot the second now. Blue Jays moving very quickly, getting the ball around fast, able to score pretty well by doing that. There's a foul after the shot. Tara Sampson rushing her pass. So in turn, you get a turnover just due to rushing the pass. Plano will steal the ball off the inbound there. She makes her open layup. Great job by Miss Asbell. Kalina does a good job getting it down the court, but passes out quickly. She'll go up, and there will be a blocking foul on the Blue Jays, maybe with a fall. Maybe with a fall, she could get the charge, but it's not the case. Tara Sampson to be subbed out as she complains about her hip. Or thigh, it seems like. I'm not exactly sure what happened there. Be a foul there. Lena will go up, fouled on her way up. That was a big fall by Kalina. She was up and I know, ended up like twisting in the air and coming down. Asbel's shot does not fall. Wolves down by 17. This is what they were down by at the beginning of the second half. Back to the talk about the female coaches. I would like to see more female coaches within basketball, just because I feel like, especially with the girls, they seem to work better. A lot of the male coaches I've seen are, I don't know, they're really aggressive. They're loud, oftentimes scream. I feel like female coaches work better with the players. I don't know. It just seems like a better dynamic, and I would like to see more of them. I think that'd be good. A great block by Tara Sampson there. Will go down as a foul. Shoot again. Owen falls there. Blue Jays doing a great job pressuring the Wolves inbound. Shelby Straley, a huge foul there. That was just blatant. Didn't really give Shelby any room to work with. It was just, I don't know, Shelby kept running and she didn't. Ended up getting hit. Tickets are on sale for Pack Night, which is Friday, March, I believe, 2nd. So if you would like tickets to that, I believe that's at Dixie Stampede. You can go get those. A great block by the Blue Jays. Down by 20 again. Is a foul on Ava Letterman. That's her second foul. And now Shelby to shoot. First one does not fall. Was shooting 1-1. Blue Jays trying to get the post play going on. She did a pretty good job, but she will be fouled. She'll go to shoot two. Misses the first, on to the second. Seconds left here in the third quarter. We'll go White way for an elbow. On number 33. Thank you. does fumble the ball there on the inbound, just unable to come up with that. She's moving. Blue Jays have done an amazing job of stopping the inbound of the Wolves. It seems the Wolves inbound has just been the same play over and over. Wonder if that was a film thing or just a they picked it up this game thing. Shelby Straley to trip on her ankle there. And it seems that Brooke Davis is injured now. Looks to be her legs, but she's able to walk off fine. So I'm sure that we'll see some of her later or later on in the season if you go to an away game. It seems she's fine, walking fine. Will be the end of the third. One thing about Kalina is you really don't see her play any different based on the score of the game. Seems no matter what the case is, she plays pretty quickly, pretty fast. She's an aggressive player. I don't know. It just seems like all the time she plays pretty well. And I think that helps carry the Wolves through some games. And in close games allows them to fight, stay in those games. But nevertheless, I do notice that out of her a lot. I mean, I'm not saying the other players don't do it, but it is just something easy to notice if you watch her effort, the intensity that she plays with, you see it. To talk about how this announcing has like helped me, or if it has helped me, if I've even noticed at all, I would say that it has helped me with public speaking. Even though I still sound like I just learned how to talk a few days ago, I do find myself able to speak about a lot of things better, more like, I'd say, in a more consistent manner, a more confident manner. I never really had an issue or like a fear to get over of, oh no, people are listening to me. What if I sound stupid? What if I mess up? I never had that fear when streaming, but the fear that I have had, or it's not really a fear, but I just felt like, how am I going to fill the space? How am I not going to be boring? Which I am boring a lot, probably, or I talk too much, probably, and I wouldn't doubt it. Both of those will be a foul there. It will go Blue Jays ball, I believe. I don't know. He pointed that way. It is okay. It is going to be Wolves ball. Okay, anyway, but it has helped me. I'm more confident about what I talk about, but I don't know. I had a fear of how am I going to fill this dead air space in the first games. I still kind of do it. I announce like a radio commentator as if you can't see things that happen, especially in football. I did that really bad, but I don't know. It does help me. I know that a lot of people have told me that I'm very bad about talking too much and I'm annoying, and a lot of people's parents have said that, and a lot of grandparents have said that. Not to me, because they were probably scared to say it to me, but they'll say it, and then the kids say it, which, I mean, I don't know, like, whatever, but it's interesting to see Shelby to shoot some more. It is interesting to see or just hear the opinions. Personally, I think I do a pretty good job. It's all that matters. My brother, he does a pretty good job during football season. We're a good team, good dynamic duo. I don't know. They just... Oh. The Blue Jay. Blue Jays little team collision there. Not the best. Both going for that free ball. But like I was saying, I mean, I think I do a good job, and a lot of people probably think it's either harder or easier. It has its difficulties, but it's also not as bad as some people may think. I'd say maybe like the fear part and the criticism part is probably the most difficult thing for anyone who wants their kid or wishes their kid or they want to do it. it's something I suggest, especially if you want to be better at public speaking. It's important. I'm a pretty good public speaker, in my opinion. And I don't know. It doesn't really bother me as much, but it is important. Blue Jays score again, extends the lead to 17, I believe. I'm checking my math. Yes, 17. But anyway, it is a great, I wouldn't say like hobby, but it is a great thing to be a part of, even if you don't want to do it for every season or anything like that. But if anyone has ever wondered, you know, has it helped you, or maybe they haven't wondered, but now they're like, oh, I never thought about that. Definitely does help me. Definitely has helped me. I don't regret doing it. And I don't know, maybe I'll be a part of some of it next year. We'll see. I know Ben Renz, who graduated last year and now is at Drury, he's helped out with the streams a little bit. He's, you know, just messed around with it, done some stuff here and there, and he comes to the games when he can, helps out, and that's good for him. And, you know, now he's in Drury, and he's, like, a part of, I believe, a media team there, some sort of something to do with or something like what we do here at Reed Spring. That's interesting to see. It's good to see, too. Some people have asked me if I want to announce as a career, and the answer is no. But also what people don't realize is, like, if you go look at professional announcers, so, like, you go watch All-Star Weekend, if you went and watched All-Star Weekend this weekend, those announcers on TV, like, those are professional basketball players that are done. They're at least college players. Like, I don't know. That's the easiest, like, thing. Like, who wouldn't want LeBron James to go announce and, like, give his opinion? Like, that would just – it'd be so easy for him to get that job because he played basketball and is one of the greatest basketball players of all time. So, I don't know. Like, it wanted to be a really hard field to get in. If you look at a smaller scale, yeah, sure, I could. But it's not like I'm super passionate about this or even sports in general. So yeah, I don't really see myself doing that, although I now know that I can never, you know, wonder, oh, maybe I wouldn't have wanted to do that. Now I know. Also, if you didn't know, the way that I started to announce was taking Mr. Locke's I think it was graphic design, it's computer art, and I never had Mr. Locke, and I didn't really want to take an art class, but I had to take an art class, and I had to get it over with, and I was already very proficient in Photoshop and computer art. Oh, power dribble, goes up for the layup, nothing there, but I don't know, and so then he was talking to me about, oh, I need someone to announce or stream in the game. They streamed a few with no announcer, and that was good for a lot of people. They could listen to Perry, which a lot of people still do, listen to Perry, and then watch our film. Excuse me, which is really good, and a lot of people do that now because they find me annoying or Colin. I think I just hit the mic. Because they would be there every single game for football. So they'd listen to him, watch our stuff, just mute it. I think there'd be like a little bit of a delay, though, on he's like live. Our stuff's like 7 seconds behind. So might be awkward. Like, hear the play, but that just shows how annoying I guess we really were because people were okay with like already hearing the play from Perry and then knowing it's coming up and then watching it. I don't know. So, yeah, they did a few like that. And then Mr. Walker was like, I need someone to announce. Do you know anyone? I said, no. And he said, what if you did it? And I said, no, I don't want to do it. I could not do it. And then he said, give it a shot. And I said, okay, I'll do it. Will be a foul there. My perspective. Looked like a clean block, but hey, I'm not wearing the striped shirt. Anyway, and so then I miraculously got my brother to do it. I don't know how. I really don't. If you know my brother, he's not someone to go to. Pretty quiet. Unless he's around people he's really comfortable with. But I don't know. That was interesting. But it was good in general that he was able to do it. It made it much more enjoyable for me. Wolves down by 16 now. I've not really been able to escape that 15 to 20 point deficit. Another thing that is good about announcing is just, I don't know, I guess like in a way kind of getting out and doing something. Like, I would never come to a girls' basketball game. If I wouldn't come to a boys' basketball game, wouldn't come to a football game unless I did this. So for me, definitely a foul on Tara Sampson there. So for me, like, this was good. And I don't know, just kind of like opened me up. I was able to watch, or like not necessarily watch, but like just come to these different events. Tara Sampson will foul out of tonight's contest. 4 minutes and 11 seconds left. Ashley Nolan subbed in there. Last Friday, I believe, or Thursday, I think, was senior night for the girls. Although this is the last home game, it's kind of weird, but it's the last game. One thing that's very awkward, though, is if people play the games out loud at school. It's weird because, like, you know, no one likes the sound of their own voice. Like, I mean, I'm okay with the sound of my voice now. When I hear it on video or some videos, it's just like, oh, gosh. Or last year, he used to get very, very excited for plays. Showed a lot of emotion. So, I mean, yeah, I showed a lot of emotion, so that was kind of weird. And I don't know, a little obnoxious, and now I tried to tone that down. More monotone, and if you know me in person, I'm very monotone. Timeout taken by the Blue Jays. Not exactly sure what she could possibly be unhappy with, as it will be a 30-second timeout. Wolves up here. Or excuse me, Wolves down here. Blue Jays up here, and not exactly sure what she is discussing right now with the team. Maybe just some simple plays that they could get down. Some revisions to the way they're playing now. Job by the Wolves contesting the inbound, trying to stop that. Ashton Nolan played a pretty good defensive score right there, but nothing she could do. Miscommunication by the Blue Jays there. Thank you. Good job by Victoria Scobie there. Not going to come up successful there on the breakaway basket. Blue Jays end up scoring off of that. Blue Jays now lead by 22. Shelby Straley is third. He's going to stay a blue ball. Victoria has to really work her magic to try to keep that ball in bounds as she started to fall out. Blue Jays score once again. A minute left here in tonight's contest here at Jim Home Court, the last basketball game that will be played here this season. Victoria's shot short. Second shot does not fall. 50 seconds left here in tonight's contest. Kalina weaves through two Blue Jays players and looked like a little bit of contact there. Just does not come up with the basket. Seconds left. Blue Jays continue to hold the ball. That will end tonight's game as the Reed Spring Wolves come up short 45-72. My last game announcing. I hope you guys loved me while I was here. But again, game over. Not really much more. Stay tuned for baseball season again. Pack night tickets will be are on sale now for Friday, March 2nd. This is in 2 weeks, not this Friday, but next, I believe. So have fun. Go to that. But that is tonight's game. We'll see you later. Goodbye.